This is a GCS Newsbreak.
Southeast High was the scene for a day dedicated to the future farmers of America. The FFA held an open house with lots of entertainment for young and old alike. In addition to the tractors and other farm machinery on display, there were plenty of farm animals as well. The guest of honor was North Carolina Commissioner of Agriculture and Guilford County resident Steve Troxler. Troxler entertained the crowd by treating some folks to a ride high atop a giant V8-powered shopping cart built to help promote buying food from North Carolina farmers. It's that time of year again. It's prom time. Students at Gateway Education Center celebrated the occasion in style in the school gymnasium. The event was complete with prom photos and music from a DJ, flashing disco-style lights. Gateway students were escorted to their prom by students from St. Pius Catholic School, as well as Wesleyan Christian Academy.
You are going to be working with our second graders today.
The GCS strategic plan includes character development as part of school curriculum. That's why you'll find Northwest Middle School students developing their character by volunteering in their community. GCS TV2 caught up with Northwest students at Pierce Elementary. They were here to help Pierce students learn to tell time.
That's perfect.
Pierce is just one of more than two dozen locations in Northwest Guilford County where middle school students are volunteering. They also visit a nursing home, a camp for children with special needs, as well as helping with landscaping duties at a variety of locations.
Because the story is actually about a pelican.
These third graders are participating in a guided reading group at Brooks Global Studies. There's a lot of emphasis put on reading here, and that's led them to a literacy award this school year. The North Carolina Reading Association recently named Brooks as the first runner-up in the state for the Exemplary Reading Program.
To know that we're doing something that's good for kids, and then for us to be, you know, second in the state for a national award, that really speaks volumes for our program.
This has been a GCS Newsbreak.